by itself, or why does it have to be divine? It's something that God gives us as a means to use. Or, you know, if you see, in our place, we worship the tiger. This is something object of fear. So, automatically, the Hindus, we choose an object of fear to be something that needs to be worshipped. I mean, I'm you will be actually shocked that if I tell you that my, you know, in our place, we have this family God thing also. There are 3 crores, 3 lakhs gods, because there is this family God for each family, and, you know, I don't know. So, my family God is a pig. What would you say on that? So during this time, this transition period, which I have, doing research and all that, I didn't tell you that I was becoming Muslim or anything. I just stopped arguing, started looking into Islam, started looking into who this person Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is. Did he do it for the sake of money? Did he do it for the sake of women? Did he do it for the sake of something else? Or for fame? If you look at the serious man, you get the answer for everything. Now, I don't have the time to answer all these questions. However, I started showing some sort of interest. And so what happened was, we didn't know something about Shahada, or even my friend didn't know, and I didn't know. So we started just becoming like, you know, many of the Muslims, like we say, Jonah Muslims, is praying Jonah. And that's how I started, you know, I don't know the exact day when I became Muslim. It was just like over a period of time that I was convinced. The more I studied about Islam, the more convinced I was. And so this went on for like a period of time. And we were just, however, I was worshipping one God. I was believing that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the final messenger. Like most Muslims think that it's only La ilaha illallah Muhammad rasulullah that can take you to Jannah. I was thinking like that, okay, that's it. And I was going for the Jummah prayers. People around me started assuming things, you know. My family, they thought that he has been experimenting, this is his new experiment, okay, let him continue. And because my manners didn't change, my habits didn't change, because I didn't know what Islam is. I just knew about Tawheed. That's all my friend told me, Tawheed, that's it. We just spoke only about Tawheed, and it was such a beautiful topic that I actually fell in love with Tawheed. It's so beautiful. And so for a period of time, the Muslims started assuming that this guy is coming only for the Friday prayers. There's something wrong, you know, maybe he's a double agent. And my family also didn't take me serious. This thing went on for a while, and after that, I decided to move on to Bangalore. Now, what happened after I came back from Bangalore, I think it's time for prayer, so let's just continue after that, inshallah. And I hope to see you all soon. I hope to raise my singles for this, inshallah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajeem. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. It's good to see all the brothers back, mashallah. And let me continue from where I stopped. There was, I had understood Tawheed, and then I moved to Bangalore. But life hadn't changed. I was just the same person. Nobody noticed any changes in me. People around me started assuming things. The most common assumption that you have back in India is that people become Muslims either for money or for marriage. So people started assuming things. Even the Muslims, some of them started coming up with stories. And my family also didn't take it so seriously. And I was also not, you know, in my heart, I decided that now I believe that there is one God. I'm going to keep that belief inside me. I'm not going to share this to anybody. Why should I simply, you know, get into trouble? So I moved to Bangalore to study animation. And then everything was the same. Like, music, friends, party, everything was the same. So I came back home, and during my vacation, I came to our place, Rodi, and it was in April, I think around 2009, yes. I had this, actually I was going with my friend on a bike, and we had a severe accident. It was a major accident, and we actually fell on top of the windshield, and on top of the car, and then we fell back. And I was actually very close to death, you know, you can say that. And that's when the whole thing you know, I start thinking about it. What if I have actually died at this very moment? What would have happened to me? What would have happened to my family? I have decided I'll keep it as a secret. Then who would have told them about Islam? If this was the truth, what did I do about it? I just believe, that's it. And that point of view, you know, I was actually looking for the answers. Although I had found Tawheed, I had not actually found the correct answer. There was happiness inside me, but I had not found the answer. At that point, I realized the verses of the Quran that actually made sense at that moment. That is, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. Allah has created jinn and mankind solely for the purpose of worshipping Him. Now what is happening is, people say they are Muslims, we say La ilaha illallah, we go to Jannah. No, that's not it. There's something more to it. And that's about living as a Muslim. That's about dying as a Muslim. Not just by saying La ilaha illallah, but by testifying it with your actions as well. That's about loving the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's about doing what Allah has asked you to do. Now all these things, at that last moment, and I had heard about all this thing, but I wasn't taking it seriously. But when I was so close to death, I knew that if I had died now, I don't know what would I be answering to my Lord on the day of judgment. That when you got the message, what do you do about it? I didn't do anything about it. So, alhamdulillah, that was the most beautiful thing. The accident that happened to me was one of the most beautiful things that Allah has given to me in my life. Alhamdulillah. And because of that, I was bedridden for 3 months. And I had a crack in my bone in the leg. And so at that point of time, I decided I need to start to do what Islam asked me to do, what Allah told me to do. I started praying secretly. I started knowing about the religion. I started knowing more about Islam. And the more I started learning about Islam, the more convinced I was. During this time, there was something else that happened also. Alhamdulillah, Allah gave me this accident as an opportunity for me to be with my family. Because before that, I used to go out of home in the morning and I used to come back sometimes maybe late at night, sometimes maybe after a week, sometimes maybe after 15 days. I used to just party and I was always bothered about my family. I actually forgot on that. I have a sister to look after. I have my mom and my dad who actually love me and all that. I'd forgotten about it because when you get into this, think about this teenage years and adrenaline rush and, you know, having fun, friends, you think this is all life is all about. You don't want somebody who pesters you all the time, who, you know, tells you what to do, this, not to do that. You want to stay away from all those things. So Allah gave me this opportunity that I be with my family. So I was bedridden. I was in the hospital for a few months, or the first month, and then I was taken to home. I was not able to walk at that point of time. And so what used to happen was, many of the Muslims knew that I became Muslim. So they used to come to visit me. And my mom was saying all this. And she used to see, this guy was born and brought up in a Hindu family. His relatives come once in a month. What's up with this Muslim visiting him every day? I'm like, she used to think, what's wrong? Something is wrong. Why are all the, you know, bearded men and women are coming as couples and, you know, with their family to see this guy? Something is wrong. But however, you know, what happens is when people become Muslims, especially, you know, if there are some Muslims out here, they think that now I'm Muslim and I go tell my family and inshallah they'll accept it. But it's not so easy, you know. You don't get up and go tell your mom I'm a Muslim and she says, okay, mashallah, you know, I'll be a Muslim. It doesn't happen like that. So alhamdulillah, Allah gave me the understanding at that point of time. So what did I do? I didn't tell them that I wanted to become Muslim. I just told them, mom, you see these people coming over here. Do you know who they are? Do you know what they believe in? Do you know whom they worship? I used to answer all your questions and she used to listen to me because, you know, I'm like sick and I'm on the bed and which are, you know. And also she was like surprised that I'm speaking to her because after long years that I started actually talking to my mom. Subhanallah. Which I actually regret now that I... Anyways. So I started telling her about how these Muslims are and what they do and what are the misconceptions that the media, the people around, that the Muslims themselves have created about Islam
And I started telling her about, you know, it's all about worshiping one God. I put stress on the fact of Tawheed. That's the only thing that can save you. Even if you have the best of manners, even if you do the best of deeds, if you don't worship Allah the way He's supposed to worship, if you associate partners with Him, if you go down to idols, if you go down to graves, if you go down to saints, if you go down to somebody else other than Allah, all your deeds are going to be in vain. I used to explain to them, but not telling them, this is what I want to do, this is what they are doing, you know. So she used to listen, okay, these people are doing that, okay, so go for it. So after 3 months of talking and telling her about scientific miracles, I forgot to mention one thing. During this point of time, actually, since I come from a Shetty family, alcohol is very common. You know, most of our businesses are based on alcohol only. So my dad was a good person. But when he used to consume alcohol, he used to get violent and he used to get harsh. And so since childhood, I had this hatred towards intoxicants. I had this hatred towards cigarette, smoking, and all the thing that makes you lose your consciousness. So I wasn't close to my dad. So this period of time, I was actually speaking more to my mom and my sister. So I used to tell them this. And after a period of 3 months, I think I had the courage to tell them that, see, this is what I am doing, this is what actually I want to become. But alhamdulillah, I softened her heart in those 3 months, and she knows that I am in a state of despair, like I am bedridden. So the mom was always full of mercy. So she told me that, okay, if this is what you want to do, okay, do it, but don't force me, don't force your family, do whatever you want. Alhamdulillah, so Allah made that transition phase very easy for me. So I advise that, you know, new Muslims especially, that when you become Muslim, and if your family members don't see a change in you, then don't expect them to be Muslims themselves. If you give 24 hours dawah to them, if you speak about compared to religion, if you speak about scientific miracles in the Quran, it won't make an impact that more than if you follow Islam the way it is supposed to be followed. So instead of, you know, just jumping on them with your dawah techniques, what you need to do is do what Allah has asked you to do. Be the best to your parents. This is what Allah has told. This is not my philosophy or somebody else's philosophy. This is what Allah has told, that you need to be very good to your parents. You can't say a word of oath. That's the word of despair to your parents. Be kind to your neighbors, you know, pray on time. Obey your parents as long as it is in obedience to the Creator. But when it comes to disobedience to Allah, you have to refuse to obey to your parents or whoever it is. And don't lie, don't cheat, you can't expect that you have been smoking so far, you are drinking, and now you become Muslim, and you're still the same, and you expect your family members to become Muslims. I mean, it doesn't work that way. Unless people around you see a change in you, they won't be convinced that there is something about this religion. So if you want to make your mom, your father, or anybody around you a Muslim, you need to change first. You need to live the life the way that Allah has asked you to live. So during this period, I told her I want to become Muslim, and then she said, okay, alhamdulillah. Then sometimes she used to actually, alhamdulillah, Allah put it in her heart that I used to walk with crutches. So I still remember she used to take me to the masjid, and she used to drop me, and she used to come back, alhamdulillah. But however, she was not able to accept Islam, because in the journey of seeking truth, the first barrier is ego. Okay, alhamdulillah, Allah guided me and I overcame that. Then the second barrier is your family. And this is what most people are stuck with. They want to accept Islam, but they say, what about my family? If you know that Allah is the one who can change hearts, you have to keep tawakkul on Him and take the decision. Allah will make it easy for you. It is important for you to save yourself first, then only you can think about your family. First save yourself and then keep tawakkul on Allah, and Allah will make it very easy for you. So at that point of time, I started praying regularly, I started keeping the prayer, mashallah, I met with some really nice Muslims, alhamdulillah, and I started learning a bit of the deen also, and also I met the Muslims, I can say, I don't know how to say that. Some people came up with theories that don't start keeping the prayer, the Sahabas used to cut the prayer, and all sorts of stories they made up, and trying to convince me, don't become like an extremist. I was like, this is what Allah asked me to do. This is what I'm doing, and it's very simple. So I started praying in the masjid. I started Allah blessed me with knowing the Muslims before Islam. That's why I used to go to the prayer and I used to see, subhanAllah, the Jummah prayers, the masjid is full and there is no space outside. And when I reach the early morning, I still at home and I'm